Welcome to VGuy TV. In this video, I'm going to give the tricks in Doppler effect. Before going for the tricks, what is called Doppler effect? The apparent change in the frequency due to the relative motion of source or observer or both. It means when the source is moving with respect to observer, there will be some change in frequency. Or observer may be moving with respect to source, also there will be some change in frequency. Or if both are moving also, there will be some change in the frequency. This phenomena is called Doppler effect. Okay, so I'm going to give the trick to solve the Doppler effect. So this is the equation for Doppler effect. The apparent frequency is equal to V plus or minus VO divided by V plus or minus VS into actual frequency. It means nu dash equals V plus or minus VO divided by V plus or minus VS into nu. Okay, so nu dash is called the apparent frequency. Nu dash is called the apparent frequency. V is called the speed of the sound. V naught is called the speed of the observer. VS is called speed of the source. Okay. Nu is the actual frequency. So I'm just writing here V is called the speed of sound. They'll give it in the question, speed of the sound. And VO is called the speed of observer. O means observer. And VS means speed of source. Okay, clear? Now I'll give a trick. You have to remember this equation, okay? V plus or minus VO by V plus or minus VS, okay? Now, I will remember that observer always at the numerator, okay? These are the tricks to remember. So, remember observer term should be in the numerator, okay? So, the other term will be in the denominator, right? So, that thing you have to remember. Now, you see, I gave four cases here. First, observer is moving, source is at rest, and observer is moving towards source. So, what is the meaning? What is the shortcut? OMSR means observer is moving, source is at rest. And how observer is moving towards the source? So, if you check this equation, the denominator term won't come because source is at rest. So, that VS won't come. Here, when we are moving, when a source or observer is moving towards means we should get more frequency. We are getting more frequency. So it means that what will happen here, if it is towards, I need to get more frequency. So the numerator should be plus. Clear? So V plus VO by V into nu. So I told two things to remember. Source is at rest, right? Here source is at rest. If the source is at rest means in the denominator this VS term won't be there. Right? That is the first thing. Another one what I told is towards. Towards means what is the meaning? Frequency should increase. Towards means frequency should increase. Frequency should increase means apparent frequency increases means I should get plus. Now see the reverse case. Observer moving, source rest, but it is away. Away means your mind should work like that. Apparent frequency should decrease. So it means that instead of plus, what we should get? Minus. Clear? If it is moving towards, it should increase. Apparent frequency should increase. If it is moving away, apparent frequency should decrease. So did you understand? So you see these two are very simple tricks. Observer moving, source rest. If it is moving towards, you see this equation, I don't have a term in the denominator, VS term not there, only numerator term by V should be there. Numerator term also, if it is moving towards, frequency increase, so I should get the plus. If it is moving away, what we should get, moving away, frequency should decrease. So, the numerator should be connected with a minus sign. So, did you get? Now, see the reverse case. Observer rest, source is moving towards. Observer rest, source is moving, but it is towards. So here what will happen? Where is your source term? Your source term is in denominator. Where is your source term? Source term is in denominator. Observer is at rest. So in numerator, we don't have VO term. We have only V. So V by next. If it is moving towards, I told frequency or apparent frequency should increase. So it means that denominator should be minus. Observer S, source moving and it is towards means you should get an idea that observer S, so in numerator VO is not there. Denominator term should come. In denominator plus or minus, which one? Because I need to get more frequency, so denominator obviously should be minus. But see the reverse case, observer S, source is moving. Observer S, source is moving, but it is away. Away means what happened to your apparent frequency should decrease. Apparent frequency should decrease means obviously your denominator should be plus. So V by V plus Vs into nu. I hope you got it. Okay, you got the trick. You need not learn all the equation. I know only this first equation. V plus or minus VO by V plus or minus Vs into nu. So how I will remember is, any case if it is towards me, frequency should increase. If source is moving towards or observer is moving towards, remember frequency should increase. Frequency should increase means plus or minus depends upon the term is in numerator or denominator. So if we are talking about the observer term, observer is moving means the terms are in the numerator. So if we need increase means numerator should be plus. If we need decrease means numerator should be minus. Numerator, this connecting term should be minus. But if you're talking about the source movement, source term is in the denominator. So if we need increase means denominator should connect with a minus sign. Here this term, if we need decrease in the frequency, denominator term should connect with a plus sign. Clear? Yes, very good. Now see the last case. Observer moving, source also moving. Both are moving away. So away means obviously you should remember, away means what happened to your apparent frequency should decrease. Should decrease means numerator term should connect with minus, but denominator term should connect with plus. Understood? You got the logic? Because if it is moving away, so I should get a lesser answer. Frequency should decrease. So it means that numerator should connect with a minus, denominator should connect with a plus. Just opposite. Observer moving, source is moving, but it is towards. So obviously your apparent frequency should increase. Apparent frequency should increase means numerator should connect with which sign? Plus sign, and denominator should connect with which sign? Minus sign. Many people will get the doubt like where we should keep plus, where we should keep minus. So nothing. It's very simple. You remember the standard basic formula, V plus or minus nu dash equals V plus or minus VO by V plus or minus Vs into nu. So you just write it like this two times, so you'll get an idea. Then no need to do it like this. Okay. You can write only this equation. Check it, which term is moving, the term in the numerator or term in the denominator. I told a very easy way, observer. So I always remember like observer, like a human being, it come in the top. So VO term should come in the top. So V plus or minus VO by V plus or minus VS, right, into nu. Now this case you remember, when observer and source both are moving, away means I should get less frequency. So it means that numerator V minus VO by V plus Vs into nu. But if both are moving towards means I should get more frequency. So it means numerator should connect with a plus, denominator should connect with a minus. I told about frequency. They can ask the questions related with wavelength. So you remember new frequency is equal to V by lambda. So from this I understood that frequency is inversely proportional to wavelength. So what all cases I told you here, frequency increases. But in the case of wavelength, it will come just reverse. So you just check it in the question whether they asked about frequency or wavelength. Sometimes we will learn, we will study this, and they may ask questions related with apparent change in the wavelength. So don't be confused. Remember any one thing. Remember about the frequency equation, and frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional. It means as frequency increases, wavelength decreases. Clear? Oh, so in short, Doppler effect questions are very simple, and apparent frequency is equal to V plus or minus VO by V plus or minus Vs into actual frequency. Clear? So you can do any question from the Doppler effect by using this concept.
Hope you understood the video. If you understood the video, and if you like the video, like and subscribe our channel, VGuide TV. Thank you.